Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel, The Town Watch. My name is Josh Town. Thank you for stopping by to this unboxing video today. Every once in a while, companies, people reach out to me asking me to look at watches, if they can send me a watch to review on the channel, and that's what happened in this case. A Chinese company reached out to me. They sell watches on Amazon, and so I looked at some of their selection and I picked one and they sent one over, so that's what we're going to look at today. They did give me this watch, but there are no stipulations from them as far as I have to make a positive review or I can't say certain things. So everything I say in this video is my own opinion and my own thoughts, whether it's good or negative, and I try and do that in all of my videos no matter what. But here is the box. And you can see it's like a leather material. I'm trying to figure out what color it is here. It's kind of like a dark brownish color. And they have that same leather feel here. It's a nice little package that the watch can come in. And looks pretty nice. Unours. I'm not sure exactly how you say that. Unour is the brand. Again, I bought this on Amazon. And then they reimbursed me for the purchase. So these are available on Amazon. I believe I paid a little over $80 for this watch, and so that's what you can expect to pay. And if you have Amazon Prime, of course you get free shipping. That's the good thing about buying Chinese watches on Amazon, is you don't have the long wait like you do if you purchase from places like AliExpress or even wish.com. Here it is. Here is the watch. Now, they brand this as a Tourbillon, but as far as I can see, I don't think it's a real Tourbillon, even though they're trying to go for that look here. I'm not one who knows everything about all the components and mechanisms of watches and complications and stuff, but I know they put that word Tourbillon in the description of this watch, but as far as I can see, I don't think this is a real Tourbillon. Someone with more knowledge than me can tell me for sure in the comments. But I believe a Tourbillon also rotates. And so I don't see any rotating here. I just see the balance wheel going back and forth. But this, I think, is probably considered more of a dressy piece. It's got a unique look to it. It has a rose gold colored case, rose gold colored hands and indices as well. And so this is just an unboxing. I'm going to do a full review of this watch as well, so stay tuned for that in the future. But in this video today, we'll at least get the calipers out and go over the dimensions of the watch. But stay tuned for a full review where I'll share all my thoughts once I can spend some time with this piece. Has anybody else found that these blue stickers are some of the hardest to get off, or is that just me? I'm going to leave that for later. All right, let's get the dimensions on the case here. It's about 41, 41 and a half or so. Get the thickness, just about 13, a little under 13 millimeters. Lug to lug distance is 50 and a half. And then we have a lug width here of 20 millimeters. So for a dress watch, in my opinion, it's a little bit large for someone like me. I usually like my dress watches, you know, between 37 millimeters, 39 millimeters. But some people might like the larger size. And so you can see it's a unique looking watch. Comes on this alligator style leather strap here. Something I notice is that the buckle is not matching the case color. They should have matched the rose gold with the buckle as well. But it's not a bad looking piece, I don't think. Some minor decoration on the movement back here. Little water resistance, I'm not sure how much, it's not noted there. And I'm not sure exactly what movement this is. Mineral crystal on the front. I did test that out with my tester here. So you can see that it is a mineral crystal, whereas my Citizen ProMaster Tough here will go up because that is sapphire. So just mineral crystal here. I don't know, for the price, they might have been able to squeeze in a sapphire crystal, I'm not sure, but there is hand winding here, and there seems to be no second hand, but you do get a subdial to the left. That is a 12-hour subdial, and then you get what looks like kind of like a moon phase thing going on, but it's really just a day-night indicator, so as the time goes around, you can see that moves to the nighttime, so you can know when the AM and PM is. Something I was a little confused about was the Roman numeral 4 that they use over here. You know, they put the 4 written out with 4 lines like that. I thought that the 4 was written with the 1 and the V. I come to find out it can be written both ways, and in most cases on watches and on clocks, they actually write it like it is right here. I didn't know that, so that's something I learned new for the first time. Well, I almost forgot to do a wrist shot, so here it is on my 6.5-inch wrist. Doesn't feel bad at all. I think the lug to lug is a little bit long for my liking here. I think it's a little over 50 millimeters, so it doesn't quite hang over my wrist, but a little bit longer than I really like to wear. But it doesn't look too bad. Doesn't look too bad. I think there is some lume on this watch, so I'm gonna take my UV flashlight, charge it up, and get a quick lume shot. Alright, so here's a quick shot of the lume. You do get some lume on the chapter ring and those squares that are there on the outside, and also some strips on the minute and hour hand as well. So, not the most potent, but it's good to have some lume, I think. So, overall, it's not a bad looking piece. You get some texture to the dial here, sunburst pattern. Looks like the logo is applied, these diamond shape indices have a nice facet to them, and they're also applied, and they throw in a couple Roman numerals there as well, which gives the watch a unique look also. So those are my first impressions of this watch. Looking forward to spending some time with it, but I want to hear from you guys down in the comments below. What do you think about this Chinese Tourbillon, at least Tourbillon look-alike, and I'd love to hear what you think about it. Do you think it's worth the little over $80 that you would pay for something like this? Let me know down in the comments, and if you're interested, you can find links to this watch down below, and they have some others in their line of watches as well. So let me know what you guys think, and if you liked this video today, please let me know by leaving a like. Hit that like button, it really helps out. And thanks for tuning in today to The Town Watch. We'll see you next time.